Chart 1 and the third part, reverse charge mechanism, person liable to pay tax. There are three type of charge: normal charge, reverse charge and ACO. So in this chapter we are going to discuss reverse charge and ACO. Normally supplier of service is liable to, supplier of goods or service is liable to pay GST, but yes, under reverse charge there are two subsections, subsection 9.3 and 9.4. 9.3 reverse charge in notified cases, irrespective of whether supplier is registered or not, that is not important. Aapka supplier registered ho ya na ho, if that goods or services are notified, then recipient is liable to pay tax. In this, okay, recipient is liable to pay tax. Now, and 9.4, there is reverse charge after amendment only in notified cases by unregistered person to registered person, but only in notified cases. So, 9.4 reverse charge today after amendment, yes, it is applicable, but only in notified cases. Some cases are notified by the government under 9.4. You will find the discussion on notified cases under 9.4 in amendment chapter. Okay, so you have to log on my website www.vsmartacademy.com/vishalsir. So you have to do login there, and thereafter you will find the separate amendments for 9.4 reverse charge. You can refer two cases, especially in construction industry, related to 9.4 reverse charge. Okay, so okay, but let's go fast. Here, 9.3 notified cases that you already know for services. For goods, this table is not applicable to you. For services, yes, this table is applicable to you. So for services, if you remember, first GTA. Do you remember that GTA? GTA 12%, GTA 5%. If GTA under 5%, then reverse charge is applicable. If supply of GTA service to notified person, that may be society, cooperative society, body corporate, partnership firm, company, LLP, AOP, BOI, if services are provided to such a notified person, okay, then under reverse charge, such notified persons are liable for payment of tax. But if GTA service is provided to other than notified person, then reverse charge is not applicable. But if you remember, then under GTA, okay, if recipient is registered under 5% category, because under 12% category normal charge GTA is liable, especially I am talking about 5% category. Under 5% category, if recipient is registered person, any person under GST, then default reverse charge is applicable. If recipient is unregistered person, in that situation रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल ओनली फॉर नोटिफाइड केसेस, ओके, कुछ ही नोटिफाइड केसेस में अप्लीकेबल है. जैसे सोसाइटी, कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी, अगर ये नोटिफाइड रिसिपियंट हो गए तो वहाँ जीटीए का रिवर्स चार्ज अप्लीकेबल होगा. तो कीप दैट चार्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू व्हेन आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज हियर. इट विल हेल्प यू टू गेट मोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द कंसेप्ट. ओके, सो हियर फॉर जीटीए वी हैव सीन. नेक्स्ट, इफ यू रिमेंबर लीगल सर्विसेस, इफ लीगल सर्विस बाय इंडिविजुअल एडवोकेट और फॉर्म ऑफ एडवोकेट और पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म ऑफ एडवोकेट प्रोवाइडेड टू बिजनेस एंटिटी, देन रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. यस, देर आर सर्टन एग्जम्पशंस दैट इफ रिसिपियंट इज अ बिजनेस एंटिटी एंड हूज टर्नओवर इन प्रीसीडिंग फाइनेंशियल ईयर इज बिलो 10 लाख्स और 20 लाख्स, 20 लाख्स फॉर जनरल कैटेगरी एंड 10 लाख्स फॉर स्पेशल कैटेगरी ऑफ स्टेट, देन एग्जम्पशन इज अवेलेबल अंडर रिवर्स चार्ज. बिजनेस एंटिटी इज नॉट लायबल टू पे टैक्स. नेक्स्ट, इफ यू सी देन अनादर वन इज आर्बिट्रल ट्रिब्यूनल. आर्बिट्रल ट्रिब्यूनल, इफ सर्विस प्रोवाइडेड बाय आर्बिट्रल ट्रिब्यूनल टू बिजनेस एंटिटी, देन रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. नाउ अनादर वन, इफ यू रिमेंबर, देन स्पॉन्सरशिप सर्विस प्रोवाइडेड बाय एनी पर्सन. स्पॉन्सरशिप सर्विस प्रोवाइडेड बाय एनी पर्सन मीन्स वॉट? सप्लायर मे बी इंडिविजुअल, बॉडी, कॉर्पोरेट, पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म, वॉट एवर इट मे बी, अ स्पॉन्सरशिप सर्विस. बट इफ रिसिपियंट इज बॉडी, कॉर्पोरेट और फर्म, देन इन दैट सिचुएशन रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल, अदरवाइज नॉर्मल चार्ज. सो इन दिस रिवर्स चार्ज यू मस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन हु इज द रिसिपियंट. ओके, ओनली टू कैटेगरी ऑफ रिसिपियंट आर सब्जेक्ट टू रिवर्स चार्ज, दैट इज बॉडी, कॉर्पोरेट और फर्म इंक्लूडिंग LLP. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन, इफ यू रिमेंबर, देन ओके इज गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेस. यस, गवर्नमेंट सर्विस रिवर्स चार्ज फॉर गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेस, सर्विसेस, एनी सर्विसेस प्रोवाइडेड बाय गवर्नमेंट या लोकल अथॉरिटी टू बिजनेस एंटिटी, देन रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. बट फॉर फोर कैटेगरीज ऑफ सर्विसेस रिवर्स चार्ज इज नॉट अप्लीकेबल. वन इज रेंटिंग ऑफ इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी बाय गवर्नमेंट टू बिजनेस एंटिटी. अनादर वन इज सर्विसेज स्पीड पोस्ट, एक्सप्रेस पार्सल पोस्ट, लाइफ इंश्योरेंस, सर्विसेज इन रिलेशन टू वेसल्स और एयरक्राफ्ट, और सर्विसेज फॉर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विस, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ गुड्स और पैसेंजर्स. सो इन दिस सिचुएशन रिवर्स चार्ज इज नॉट अप्लीकेबल, नॉर्मल चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. बट देयर इज वन अनादर एंट्री, दैट रेंटिंग ऑफ इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी बाय गवर्नमेंट और लोकल अथॉरिटी. इफ रेंटिंग ऑफ इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी बाय गवर्नमेंट और लोकल अथॉरिटी टू रजिस्टर्ड पर्सन अंडर GST, दिस क्लॉज यू मस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर, टू रजिस्टर्ड पर्सन अंडर GST, देन इन दैट सिचुएशन रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. तो ये आपके लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है. देन यस, सर्विसेस बाय डायरेक्टर टू कंपनी, सर्विसेज बाय डायरेक्टर टू कंपनी, दैट ऑल्सो अप्लीकेबल. इन दैट केस कंपनी इज लायबल टू फेस टैक्स अंडर रिवर्स चार्ज. इंश्योरेंस एजेंट टू इंश्योरेंस कंपनी, रिकवरी एजेंट टू बैंकिंग कंपनी और फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन, डायरेक्ट सेलिंग एजेंट टू बैंकिंग एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन, ओके, इन दिस केस रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. सम न्यू रिवर्स चार्ज आर इंट्रोड्यूस, ओके, आई एम रेफरिंग ओके दिस चार्ट, बट सम न्यू रिवर्स चार्ज इफ यू रिमेंबर, देन इफ सर्विसेज ऑफ TDR, ट्रांसफर ऑफ डेवलपमेंट राइट्स, और FSI, सो FSI इन कंस्ट्रक्शन इंडस्ट्री, दिस FSI इज ट्रांसफर टू प्रमोटर बिल्डर, देन अंडर दैट केस रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. इफ लीज, एनी लैंड गिवन ऑन लीज टू बिल्डर प्रमोटर मोर देन 30 ईयर्स, इन दैट सिचुएशन रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. ऑल्सो यस, कॉपीराइट्स, लिटरेरी वर्क, ओरिजिनल लिटरेरी वर्क, ओके, टू हियर प्रोड्यूसर और पब्लिशर एक्सेट्रा, देन इन दैट केस रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. इफ यू रिमेंबर, ओवरसीइंग कमिटी टू RBI, रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. इफ सर्विस प्रोवाइडर आउटसाइड इंडिया है और रिसिपियंट इन इंडिया है, तो इन दैट सिचुएशन रिवर्स चार्ज इज अप्लीकेबल. बट वन न्यू रिवर्स चार्ज मैकेनिज्म इज इंट्रोड्यूस, दिस टाइम न्यू एंट्री इज इंट्रोड्यूस, दैट इज सिक्योरिटी सर्विसेस. इफ यू रिमेंबर, ओके, दैट इज अ न्यू इंट्रोडक्शन इन अमेंडमेंट. सिक्योरिटी सर्विसेस प्रोवाइडेड बाय बॉडी, कॉर्पोरेट और फर्म टू रजिस्टर फर्म, रजिस्टर पर्सन, देन sorry, security services provided by any person other than body corporate, then in that situation, reverse charge is applicable if service provided to registered person. So there are various situations of reverse charge, all with all amendments already we have seen. I hope before doing this questionnaire, you are doing all those amendments. Okay, or in regular course or fast track class, you already have done all those amendments. On that basis, we are solving this questionnaire. Okay, beta. So let's turn to questionnaire under reverse charge. So beta, total 29 questions are there, and also multiple choice questions are there. I am going to discuss some limited questions. Question number 6. Okay, which are important for our discussion? Question number 6, question number 7, 11, 18, 15, 18, 15, 19, 20, 24, 27, 28, and 29. Okay, so these important questions I am going to discuss with you about a reverse charge. Okay. Which I feel ki it must have discussion to get a clear understanding of the concepts. Well, let's have a discussion on some specific questions of reverse charge. First, I want to take question number 6. What is the effect of reverse charge on ITC? A very important question and good question for our discussion. What is the effect of reverse charge on ITC? See, let's discuss the effect from both point of view, supplier and recipient. A supplier who is supplying goods or services, for that recipient is liable to pay tax under reverse charge. And recipient also outward supplier for that is liable to pay tax on their outward supplier. If you remember the definition of ITC under topic of ITC chapter input tax credit, what do you mean by ITC? ITC also includes any tax paid by recipient under reverse charge. That means for payment of outward tax on outward supply, he can take the ITC of whatever the tax paid under reverse charge on notified services. So, aise case mein, wo pehle tax pay karega, he will first pay the tax and thereafter will take the ITC, okay, against it outward supply. So, this is regarding to beta, yahan pe first effect. Thereafter, from supplier angle, who is supplying such notified services or goods under reverse charge, either 9.3 or 9.4, agar supplier supply kar raha hai, then as per section 17.3, his supply would be treated as exempt supply because he is not going to pay any GST to the government. So, in that case, whatever the inputs he has purchased or capital goods he has purchased or input services he has purchased, okay, he is not eligible for ITC. Yes, he is not eligible for ITC. Usse koi ITC nahi milega. Isle, if we take the example of insurance agent, in case of insurance agent, insurance company is liable to pay tax. So, whatever the tax paid by insurance company under reverse charge, eligible for ITC. But, agent who is supplying the service called as exempt service under section 17.3, and he cannot take the ITC of inputs, capital goods or input services, whatever he purchased for supplying insurance service as an agent. So this is very important impact from both the angle, from recipient is eligible to take ITC, but for supplier it is an exempt supply and not eligible to take the ITC. This is question number 6, which I think important. Then also next question number 7, is reverse charge applicable on payment of advance? Take example, a supplier supplying the goods to recipient. Supplier supplying the goods to recipient. But before supplier, okay, recipient is making the payment of advance. Advance. So, take example, a lawyer service. I am the business entity, V-Smart Academy business entity. Taking lawyer service, for that V-Smart has given advance of rupees 50,000 to individual advocate. So V-Smart and advocate, legal service, for that I have paid advance. Okay, very technical question. Whether I am liable to pay GST under reverse charge, okay, as a recipient under reverse charge on advance. See beta. Yes, on advance I am also liable to pay tax to the government as a business entity. Why? If you see section 12.3 or 13.3, time of supply, ye chapter aapka ho gaya hoga. If you see this section 12.3 and 13.3, then in 12.3 or 13.3 you will find that in case of reverse charge, matlab if liability under reverse charge of notified cases, then your TOS, time of supply, is date of receipt of goods in case of goods, or date of payment. Date of payment, this date of payment, yeah, 31 day or 61th day if you remember. So date of payment is important here. What it means, whenever you will make the payment, that also relevant for the fixing time of supply. So in case of goods, date of receipt of goods, date of payment, or 31st or 61st day from the supplier's invoice, whichever is earlier. What is important, whichever is earlier. So if you making the payment earlier, that means advance. Agar aapne advance pehle de diya, to wo case mein advance pe bhi reverse charge ki applicability aayegi. Aur agar aapne advance pay kar diya to lawyer and etc., to uske upar bhi aapko tax dena padega. Ye bhi ek achha question hai. Question number 7. Next question number 11. X Limited, a trader, has aggregate turnover of outward supply up to 10th December 2018 is 12 lakhs. He is under threshold, hence not registered under GST. Very good. X Limited taken a sponsorship services from Mr. Virat on 10th December 2018. Whether X Limited is liable to register under GST? Also explain his tax liability. Now, this is related to sponsorship service. What we have discussed for sponsorship service under reverse charge? If you remember, supplier of service, any person, and recipient is body corporate or partnership firm, including LLP. Partnership firm here, including LLP, and a recipient body corporate LLP hoga, then in that situation, okay, this body corporate or LLP is liable. What happened in this case? Recipient is X Limited, has taken sponsorship service from Virat, I think so. Yes, Virat, who is an individual. Supplier of service, any person. Don't bother for that. Supplier of service, any person. If recipient is body corporate, X Limited is body corporate, then reverse charge is applicable. But what is the technical point in this case study? X Limited, for their turnover, X Limited having turnover only of 12 lakhs, and he is unregistered person for their outward supply, because threshold is available up to 20 lakhs and exclusively for goods up to 40 lakhs on certain conditions. So in that situation he is under threshold. But what happened? Okay, he has taken the service which are notified under section 9.3 for reverse charge, that is sponsorship service. What is the special feature of 9.3? Whether supplier or recipient registered or not, if service or goods notified under section 9(3), then recipient must pay the tax thereon. That means we don't have concern with whether Virat is registered or not, here X Limited is registered or not. If service is notified under section 9(3), then recipient, that is X Limited, is liable to pay tax. Then what is the next question? Sir, but X Limited is unregistered. So if he is unregistered at the time of taking the service under reverse charge, then section 24, compulsory registration. What section 24 said, if any service taken under reverse charge 9(3) or 9(4), then recipient has to take a registration compulsorily within 30 days. Yes, registration compulsorily within 30 days. In such situation, okay, X Limited here has to take a registration, okay, under GST and required to pay the tax to the government. Okay, तो वो government को देना ही पड़ेगा उसे X Limited को. Then अब problem क्या है? Problem ये है बेटा. What is the problem here? Okay, as soon as the X Limited take the registration under GST, just because of reverse charge, he become a taxable person, a registered person, taxable person. So his unexhausted limit of 8 lakhs or whatever it may be depends on threshold. So it unexhausted limit of threshold get taxable. Why? Because of registration, he become a taxable person. So remaining his turnover of outward supply also subject to GST, he become a taxable person. So this is also a good question about reverse charge. Ye humne dekha. Next, question number 15. V-Smart Private Limited Pune has appointed senior advocate, Ms. Pooja, for representation of company's legal matter at Delhi. As regarding to representation of matter there, determine GST liability as who is liable to pay. Would your answer differ if V-Smart Private Limited appoints local advocate, Mr. Sagar, who further appoints Mrs. Pooja for representation? No. Try to understand. This question is again a very important question. There are three elements involved in this question. First, senior advocate appointed by V-Smart business entity. Senior advocate is appointed by V-Smart business entity. Now, as per provision of reverse charge, legal service provided, including representation service. So legal service also includes representation service. That point must you must have to write in exam in one line. If legal service provided by individual advocate, including senior advocate or firm of advocate, to business entity, then business entity is liable for payment of tax. So V-Smart is a business entity. So your first answer, V-Smart is liable to pay tax under reverse charge, even though service taken from senior advocate. But another point is important. What is another point? Here, which I personally think, I am not explaining in detail here because that is not more emphasized, but for conceptual point of view, okay, concept समझने के लिए a next point is very important. Okay, वो next point क्या है? Would your answer differ if V-Smart Private Limited appoint? Would your answer differ if V-Smart Private appoint local advocate Mr. Sagar, who further appoints Ms. Pooja for representation? Now, senior advocate Pooja. Now, V-Smart appointed a local advocate Mr. Sagar. and Sagar first appoint, then thereafter Sagar appointed, okay, Miss Pooja. Now, here there are two contracts, contract one and contract two. Okay, beta. So, first of all, take a supply between Mr. Sagar, a local advocate, and V Smart. Sagar and V Smart, again, individual advocate, providing services to business entity, providing services to business entity. Let's take example, this contract is of 1 lakh. Then in such case, okay, again, business entity is liable to pay tax. So V Smart is liable to pay tax under reverse charge on this 1 lakh. Now, second contract between senior advocate, Ms. Pooja, and Mr. Sagar. Both are advocate. And in this case, senior advocate providing the service to Mr. Sagar, because Mr. Sagar here has appointed Ms. Pooja for further representation. So here, Ms. Pooja will give invoice to Mr. Sagar. Take example, 80,000, this invoice. So in such case, who is liable to pay tax? This explanation from me, not given in answer and not required also, but from conceptual point of view, very, very important. If you remember the exemption, legal service exemption, agar aapko yaad nahi hoga, if you don't remember that, then refer exemption chapter legal sector. If senior advocate provides service to another advocate, come on, okay, try to understand. Senior advocate provide the service to another advocate, then exemption is not available. One individual advocate provides the service to another individual advocate, then exemption is available. But if senior advocate provides the service to another advocate, exemption is not available unless threshold, that 20 lakhs exemption of recipient, refer that exemption carefully. So in such case, assume that turnover of Mr. Sagar in preceding financial year, वो book अभी open करके रखना exemption के मेरे सामने है, तो आपको बहुत clear समझेगा. You will understand clearly if you refer that exemption. तो Mr. Sagar का preceding financial year में turnover जो है, okay, वो turnover यहाँ assume करो कि 20 lakh से ज़्यादा है. तो अगर senior advocate another advocate को services provide करता है, it provides to another advocate, then liable to GST. And in such case, Mr. Sagar is also a business entity, and if his turnover is more than 20 lakhs in PFY, then Sagar under reverse charge will pay the tax because it is a business entity. Okay, so for this contract, Sagar will pay the tax if turnover more than 20 lakhs in PFY. If below 20 lakhs, then exemption available. In such case, no exemption. Okay, in such case, business entity is liable to pay tax. So there are three elements involved in this case study. Hence, this case study is very important. I hope you understood this case study. Okay, see, I am using very simple English. I don't think any difficulty to get clear understanding. I don't think so, okay, you are facing any difficulty to get clear understanding of these concepts. Now, next here, this is, see, first, I have given a reference of 9.3. You must also have to add one point that here ki representation services and legal service. And especially, V Smart is in both the cases, if service taken from Ms. Pooja or Sagar, V Smart is liable to pay tax. Huh. But a contract between Ms. Pooja and Sagar, it depends on turnover of Sagar in PFY, because senior advocate provide the service to another advocate and liability will be decided accordingly. So this question 15 is a very good question. Next, question number 18. ABC Cooperative Housing Society avail transport service of Sharma Transport Private Limited for transport of goods by road on a consignment agreement. This is related to GTA. Determine the implications as per GST. That means Sharma Transport is a GTA and ABC Cooperative Housing Society is taking the services. As per, okay, first of all, no need to write notification number and etc. Just here you can quote that as per section 9.3, if services are provided by GTA to registered person under GST or notified person includes cooperative society, then reverse charge is applicable. So in this case, cooperative society is notified and reverse charge is applicable. And ABC Housing Society will be liable to pay GST. But you must write one note that GTA has opted to pay tax under 5%. This reverse charge is applicable only if GTA has opted 5% rate. So this comment is very important. Okay, so beta, this is question 18. Then next, 19. Question number 19. PMC being a local authority, registered under CGST Act. Okay, PMC a local authority, registered under GST Act, only for the purpose of deducting tax under section 51 and not engage in making any taxable supply of goods or services. Very, very important, only for the deduction of TDS and not doing any outward supply which is taxable. PMC avail transport service of RV Transport Company, GTA service availed by PMC for transportation of goods by road. Determine the tax implication of GST. A very, very important for your attempt. This is based on amendment of CGST Amendment Act 2018. Also a notification in this regard. See, if already you have been referred that amendments, then in amendments for GTA, one proviso is added. What is that proviso? Nothing in this reverse charge provision applicable if GTA service is provided to government or local authority which are registered only for the purpose of TDS purpose and not providing any outward taxable supply. I repeat, not providing any outward taxable supply. So, in such case, if they are not providing any outward taxable supply, then reverse charge is not applicable. In simple words, if GTA providing services to government or local authority, even though government or local authority is a registered person, come on, even though government or local authority is a registered person, I repeat, registered person, reverse charge is not applicable. Why I am emphasizing on the registered person? Because if you see a list, and agar mera notes aapke saamne hai, I think clause number C or D, something is there. If any service provided by GTA to registered person, then reverse charge is applicable. And registered person includes any person, including government or local authority. So what is the simple logic? Ki if government is registered or local authority is registered and has taken a GTA service, reverse charge is applicable. But one special proviso is added. And in that proviso, it is clearly mentioned that if government or local authority is registered only for the purpose of deduction of TDS, then this reverse charge is not applicable. Now another question. Sir, if this reverse charge is not applicable, that means can we take a meaning that GT is liable under normal charge? No, beta. If you refer exemption correspondingly, along with this, when exemption is added, I have covered in amendment, when exemption is added, and what is that exemption? if GTS service is provided to government or local authority who only registered for deduction of TDS, then GST is not payable. In simple words, GST is not payable under forward charge as well as reverse charge. But I want to explain this from another angle. If government or local authority is registered and also supplying outward taxable supply, matlab they are only not registered for TDS, also supplying outward taxable supply, in that case reverse charge is applicable. So this is important. So I have covered each and everything. The person includes government, registered person, first point, your point should be okay here clear. Second, reverse charge activity, that proviso newly added, amended, you have to write there. And generally, okay, in this case reverse charge is not applicable. From your side you can add one point more, that in this case exemption also available if service provided to government or local authority who only registered for the purpose of deducting TDS. So point of exemption you can write here, exemption, okay, for that you have to refer exemption notifications. So this is question number 19. Next hum discuss karenge question number 20. Again important question, you can write here. Question number 20. The Professional Security Pune, a firm of security agency providing services by way of supply of security personnel to following categories of person. Now under reverse charge one more entry is introduced, that is for security services. If you remember, let's revise within 2 minutes some important points of security services. If security services provided by any person other than body corporate to registered person under GST, then under reverse charge a registered person under GST is liable to pay tax. This is point number 1. Point number 2, there are two exceptions. If recipient who is a registered person is government or local authority and registered only for TDS purposes and not supplying any other outward taxable supply, matlab koi wo dusre taxable nahi supply kar raha, only registered for the purpose of TDS, then this reverse charge is not applicable. In that case, under forward charge, security agency is liable to pay tax. So what is the difference between GTA and the security services? In both the entries, you will find this proviso, that is government or local authority registered only for TDS purpose. But in GTA, reverse charge is not applicable, as well as exemption also available. But in security agency, exemption is not available. Means, in simple word, if security agency services providing services to government or local authority who are registered only for the purpose of deducting TDS, then in that case under forward charge security agency is liable to pay tax. Now second exception, that service provided to registered person is for composition scheme. If security agency is providing services to such composite dealer who is registered under composition scheme, then this reverse charge is not applicable. Under forward charge, security agency is liable for payment of tax. This is a new entry, an important discussion we have made. Third, when security agency is liable under forward charge, when they provide services to unregistered person, or if security agencies are the body corporate, that means in 4 cases security agency under forward charge are liable for payment of tax. First, if security agency is body corporate. Second, security agency providing services to government or local authority registered only for the purpose of deducting TDS or governmental agencies. Third, if they are providing services to such dealer who are under composition scheme, and fourth a dealer, if they are providing to unregistered dealer in a taxable territory, sorry, unregistered dealer. Now another important point, this reverse charge is applicable if recipient is registered person in a taxable territory. Means if security agency providing services to a person who is not in taxable territory, then reverse charge is not applicable. Under that forward charge, security agency is liable for payment of tax. This is some important provision. So before solving the problem in questionnaires, if you refer my chart or if you refer booster or your regular notes, then that would be more beneficial to you to get a clear understanding on the questions what you are going to solve here. So let's try this question. A professional security Pune, a firm of security agency providing services by way of supply of security personnel to following categories of person. XYZ Private Limited. First of all, security agency is a firm, matlab not a body corporate. If it is not a body corporate, then it would fall under the reverse charge, depend upon who is the recipient, and doesn't fall in exception. The professional security Pune, a firm of security agency providing services by way of supply of security personnel, XYZ Limited, company registered under GST valuing 10 lakhs. Obviously, here reverse charge is applicable, correct? XYZ Limited, reverse charge. Okay. Now, in this problem, we have to calculate taxable value of professional security services. Now, what is important here? Here, you have to calculate taxable value of professional services. Hence, whatever the activities under reverse charge, that would not be a taxable value of professional security services. Here, we have to calculate only the taxable value of this company. So, it's under reverse charge. You will not find any value in taxable value. Second, Sindh Cooperative Credit Society, Mumbai, which is not a registered under GST. Okay, first of all, Sindh Cooperative Society, unregistered person, unregistered person. In such case, normal charge is applicable. And under normal charge, professional courier, security services is liable, value is 8 lakhs. Now, next one. Department of Central Government located at Bangalore, which have taken a registration under CGST Act only for the purpose of deducting tax under Section 51 and not for making any taxable supply out of goods or services valuing 12 lakhs. See, if service provided to government and this government is registered only for the purpose of TDS, then in such case, again reverse charge is not applicable. Under forward set, security agency is liable for payment of GST. हाँ, अगर यहाँ थोड़ा चेंज होता कि इफ गवर्नमेंट आल्सो सप्लाइंग आउटवर्ड टैक्सेबल सप्लाई देन रिवर्स चार्ज वुड बी एप्लीकेबल, बट हियर ओनली दे आर रजिस्टर्ड फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ डिडक्टिंग टीडीएस, हेंस रिवर्स चार्ज इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल एंड आल्सो लाइक जीटीए एग्जम्पशन नॉट अवेलेबल हियर, बट इन जीटीए एग्जम्पशन इज अवेलेबल, सो इट्स टैक्सेबल. ओके, 12 लैक्स अंडर फॉरवर्ड चार्ज. Pune Municipal Corporation registered under CGST 2017 for the purpose of making taxable supply of goods or services. Value of service provided is 4 lakhs. Now try to understand. Pune Municipal Corporation, again a local authority, fall under the exceptions. But exception is applicable only for those government or local authority who are registered for deducting TDS. Here, Pune Municipal Corporation is registered for their outward supply also. Hence, reverse charge is applicable and Pune Municipal Corporation is liable for payment of tax and it would not be included in the value of supply of security agency. Next, service provided to Mr. Altaf from Gujarat, registered under section 10 of CGST Act. Service provided in Gujarat, hence it would fall under interstate supply, and the value is 2 lakhs. Oho. Value is 2 lakhs only. First of all, service provided to a person who is under a composition scheme, hence reverse charge is not applicable. Under forward charge is taxable. In answer, by mistake, 12 lakhs is given. Okay, it should be 2 lakhs. Make the correction here. It should be 2 lakhs. Okay, it is under forward charge. Next, service provided to Star Industry Limited USA, valuing being 7 lakhs. Service provided to foreign party. So, in a non-taxable territory, okay, register person in non-taxable territory, hence forward charge is applicable. But if he fulfilled the condition of zero rate supply, then exemption is also available. So I have taken in taxable value, but if you see the right side, one note is given, if it fulfill the benefits of zero rate supply, then benefit is available subject to conditions. So in problem, I have taken in taxable value, but accordingly you have to write. If you want to take at a zero rated supply, then don't take in taxable value. So it's on your note. So now three activities are taxable under forward charge. 1, 2 and four activities are taxable. Here 8 lakhs as the intrastate supply, CGST or SGST is calculated. Thereafter 12 plus 2, I have taken this way, 12 plus 2, 14 lakhs again as the intrastate supply. Sorry, as here interstate supply. You have to write here interstate supply. Do one correction there. Interstate supply 14 lakhs on which IGST is calculated. And export, that Star Industry, okay, 7 lakhs, 1,26,000, IGST 18% is taken. IGST 18% is taken beta here. But I have given the note here that if this export is under zero rate, then no need to calculate IGST and no need to pay that amount. So this is question number 20, important question for your exam. Next, that is notified cases, some amendment for this 9-4, notified cases from unregistered to registered, some amendments are there, two situations are covered, so already have covered in amendments. Well, let's discuss question number 24. Mr. X, a Delhi resident, submit a cab request to Speed Cabs for travelling from Delhi to Gurgaon. Speed Cab is a mobile application owned and managed by Speedport Technologies Limited, located in India. The application facilitates a potential customer to connect with person providing cab services under the brand name of Speed Cabs. After Mr. X pays the cab charges using his debit card, he gets the details of driver of Mr. Y and cab registration number. With reference to the Goods and Service Tax Act, discuss who is liable to pay GST in this case. Will your answer different if Speed Technologies Limited located in New York and does not have a representative in India? First, try to understand the legal provision. What is the legal provision? This case study is based on Section 9.5, that is ACO. Section 9.5 applicable for notified services, not for goods, only for services. If the notified services are supplied, I repeat, notified services are supplied through ECO, in that case, ECO is liable to pay tax, point number one. Point number two, if ECO is outside, located outside India, then their representative will pay tax. And if there is no presence of representative, then ECO has to appoint any person in India for the payment of tax. Okay, this is the provision. Now, cab service, transportation of goods by passenger. Okay, do you remember that chart? Transportation of goods by passenger is a notified services. In first notified services, whether cab operator is registered or not, this is very important statement. Whether cab operator is registered or not, completely irrelevant. If that cab operator providing services through ECO, then only ECO is liable to pay tax. 100% liability is on ECO. So, this case study based on cab operator. So, in this case, completely ECO is liable to pay tax. Now, second question they ask, will your answer is different if Speed Technology is located in New York? If Speed Technology is located in New York, then in that situation, a representative or they have to appoint any person for payment of tax in India, but only ECO has to pay the tax. This is very important explanation I have given here. Next question. Question number 25. Again, important question. Alpha Private Limited Pune provides housekeeping services. Housekeeping services. Company supplies its services exclusively through e-commerce, ECO. Website owned and managed by Clean India Private Limited, Pune. ECO name is Clean India Private Limited. The turnover of Alpha Private Limited in the current financial year is 18 lakhs. The housekeeper's turnover is 18 lakhs. Let's design the case study. Alpha turnover 18 lakhs. Now supplying services through ECO. Name of ECO is Clean India Private Limited and recipient housekeeping services. Now advise Alpha Private Limited as to whether they are required to obtain GST registration. The question here, whether Alpha Private Limited required to obtain GST registration first. Will your advice be any different if Alpha Private Limited sells ready-made garments exclusively through e-commerce website owned and managed by Clean India Private Limited, ICAI mock test paper August 2018. Now, what the student will do, common mistake in this question. Now, housekeeping, ECO, as soon as, jaise unhone case study padha, as they read this case study, they will connect to section 9.5 and will start to write section 9.5. But read this question carefully. The question not mainly based on 9.5. The question is based on registration, section 22 and 24. First, they have given a turnover of Alpha, that is 18 lakhs, who is doing the services who is supplying the services through ECU. Now for supplier of service, threshold is available up to 20 lakhs, point number one. But in section 24, if any goods or services supplied through ECO, who is liable for deduction of TCS, then compulsory registration required except for services which given by notification. Hence, before solving these questions, open that chapter registration, section 24. Section 24, I think point number 5th or 6th, when supply through ECO required to deduct TCS. But first of all, here housekeeping services, let's try to understand step by step. Housekeeping services is notified services under section 9.5. If any services notified under section 9.5, the question of TCS is not applicable and 100% liability is on ECO. Now, assume that on the basis of turnover, alpha, alpha private limited is not a registered person. Under section 9.5, keep both the provisions in front of you. Under section 9.5, first cab service, where cab operator is registered or not, whatever the supply made through ECO, ECO is liable. But for remaining two services, hotel and housekeeping, 9.5 applicable only if supplier and a housekeeping service provider is unregistered person, then under 9.5 ECO is liable to pay tax. Here turnover is 18 lakhs. We can assume that Alpha Private Limited is unregistered person. Hence, under 9.5, ECO is liable to pay tax and Alpha Private Limited not required to register under GST. This is the first case. Second, also you can write, if Alpha Private Limited is registered person, then 9.5 is not applicable, housekeeping services. In that situation, let's try to understand the case study. Thereafter, a presentation I have given in notes, you can read that. Agar wo registered hota, to in that situation, TCS section 52 would be applicable. And wo case mein bhi, agar aap 24 open karke dekhte ho, section 24, तो सर्विसेज के लिए 20 लाख तक का थ्रेशोल्ड अवेलेबल है, गुड्स के लिए नहीं. फॉर सर्विसेज यू आर सप्लाइंग थ्रू ईसीओ, यू आर लायबल टू डिडक्ट टीसीएस. फॉर सर्विसेज 20 लाख थ्रेशोल्ड इज अवेलेबल, सो इन दैट केस आल्सो नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू रजिस्ट्रेशन. बट दिस बेनिफिट नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर गुड्स. कम ऑन, दिस बेनिफिट इज नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर गुड्स. हेंस इन द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, Will your advice be any different to Alpha Private Limited sell ready-made garments exclusively through e-commerce website and managed by Clean India Private Limited? Instead of supplying housekeeping services, if they supply ready-made garments to Clean India Private Limited, then here ECO required to deduct TCS under section 52. And for goods, compulsory registration is there for supplier. Hence, in given case, we can say that Alpha Private Limited required to register compulsory, especially for ready-made garments. So, see the way of presentation, what I see, I expect from you. First, you have to write section 22, that about threshold. Then section 24, compulsory registration, that means your focus is on compulsory registration. Don't start with 9.5. See, if question is based on registration, you can refer 9.5, but answer should be start with section 22, 24. Then 9(5) issue liability. Then, okay, what do you mean by issue also covered? Then 9(5) notification is also covered. Now, concluding paragraph dekho. In given case, Alpha Private Limited provides housekeeping services through an ECO. It is presumed that Clean India is an ECO which is required to collect tax at source under section 52. However, housekeeping service provided by Alpha Private Limited, which are not liable for registration under 22(1), as is turnover less than 20 lakhs, is a service notified under section 9(5). Because turnover less than 20 lakhs, since we can assume that unregistered and 9(5) is applicable, under 9(5), supplier need not to register. Also, for services, अगर ये 9(5) में नहीं भी होता, sorry, ये तो under, sorry, this is an unregistered person under 9(5). In that case, ECO is 100% liable and Alpha Limited not required to register. But for ready-made garments, yes, under section 24(9), compulsory registration is required for goods beta. So this is regarding to यहाँ पे ECO. But I want to bring one difference. Here housekeeping is given and housekeeping is supplied through ECO to customer. If housekeeping service provider is unregistered, then 9(5) is applicable and supply is not required to register. But if he is a registered person, then TCS concept is applicable. Okay. For other services, I want to bring, okay, ek baat dhyan se sunna. Ye to housekeeping 9(5) mein notified hai, isliye theek hai. Lekin other services bhi, agar aap ECO ke through supply karte ho, jo 9(5) mein notified nahi hai, aur ECO ke through supply kar rahe ho, wo ECO jo TCS ke liye liable hai, lekin 24(9) agar aap padhoge, if you read that 24(9), then in 24(9), for all services, threshold of 20 lakhs is given, even though supplied through ECO. So this point is very important, you must keep in mind. In this example, housekeeping is covered in 9(5), hence, wo bach gaya, he saved from registration. But for other services also, if you supplied through ECO, there is one exception notification, no need to register. So this is a good question. Now question number 27. Royal Suits Company, Delhi, a registered supplier, has furnished the details of following few transactions which took place in November 2020. This question was asked in IPC RTP 2018 May. Now serial number, date, particulars and date of invoice and amount is given. Here, serial number 1, date of payment, date is 11th November 2020, payment made to advocate in Delhi, date of invoice is 7th of July 2020, amount 1,25,000, second, 28th November 2020, paid sitting fees to director from the Haryana for meeting held on here 15/10/20, date of invoice and amount. Also different GST rates are given. You are required to compute GST, CGST, SGST or UTGST as the case may be, or IGST as the case payable for the month of November, along with a time of supply as aforementioned activity. Now this is the solution which is given. Try to understand. In this problem, they have given two activities and these two activities are notified under reverse charge. Means, you have to calculate GST, you have to take three decisions. In this problem, first, whether transaction is intrastate or interstate, intrastate or interstate. Then second, you have to calculate GST accordingly. Calculate GST accordingly. Third, okay, also fix the time of supply. You have to fix the time of supply. Now, first payment made by Royal Sweet Company in Delhi. Hence, transaction is intrastate. The first transaction is intrastate transaction. Second payment made to Director of Haryana. Hence, it is interstate transaction. Interstate transaction. No doubt. For that, you have to apply Section 1213. And yes, as per Section 12 of IGST Act, first transaction is intrastate and second is interstate based on LOS and POS. Now, both the activities are under reverse charge. If you remember, service supplied by director to the company, then in that situation, company is liable. Second, service supplied by advocate to here, Royal Sweet Company, then in such case, a business entity is liable for payment of tax. Now, second one. So, in first case, you have to calculate CGST and SGST, and in second case, you have to calculate IGST. Okay. Now, next, you have to fix the time of supply. Here, Royal Sweets Company has paid the amount under reverse charge. Hence, for fixing the time of supply, we have to use for services Section 13, because both are the services. Section 13, Section 13.3, I repeat, Section 13.3, you have to fix the reverse charge. Hence, if you don't remember Section 13, pause this video, go to that section, Section 13, Subsection 3, refer that sections, and then okay, play this video. So it will help you to get clear understanding of Section 13.3. What Section 13.3 said? Section 13.3 said, in case of reverse charge, any service is procured, then your time of supplies, date of payment. In date of payment, there are two factors. One, book entry or debit it to bank, whichever is earlier. Or second, 61th day from supplier's invoice. So, in this case, 11th November is the date of payment. And supplier's invoice is on 7th of July. If you calculate 61 days from 7th of July, because you require two data. Which two data, beta? If you remember, then date of payment or 61th day. So date of payment is 11th of 2020, and 61 day from supplier's invoice, if you calculate on this calculator, okay, then it would be 6th of September 2020. If it is 6th on September 2020, then whichever is earlier, the earlier is 61th day, hence first case or time of supply is 6th of September 2020. Now, you have to calculate CGST, SGST. Also, in answer, interest is calculated, but about interest, we will discuss this further. Okay, now next one. Director sitting fees. In director sitting fees, again reverse charge, Section 13.3 is applicable. Date of payment is 20th November. Supplier's invoice is 15th of October. If supplier's invoice 15th of October and 61th day from 15th October, okay, try to understand, 61th day from 15th October, so if you calculate, then definitely you will find date of payment is earlier than 60th day. Hence, time of supply is 20th of November. You have to calculate IGST. But in this case, no need to calculate interest. Why? Because the time of supply fall within the month of November, and we have to calculate GST liability for the month of November. But in first case, time of supply, okay, is in September, for which due date is 20th October. But assessees failed to make the payment of GST by 20th of October. By 20th of October, in such situation, we have to calculate interest. Now, this is the solution of the problem. Another, you have to write the notes, because because ICAI will expect from you our notes, our institute definitely expect from you our notes, you must have to write. So in such notes, okay, how to fix the number of notes? First, you have to specify both the activities are under reverse charge. Next, you also have to write the note on section 13.3. Hence, okay, see, activities under reverse charge, then provision of section 13. Okay, how GST is payable under 13.3. Then, okay, also interstate or intrastate supply, you have to fix there. In note number 4, they have calculated the interest, but in RTP, they assume that date of payment to, in first case, date of payment to advocate is also date of payment of tax. That means if you see the problem, when the payment is made to the advocate, 11th of November, come on, 11th of November. So same date is assumed or date of payment of tax. So due date, because time of supply fall within the month of September, hence due date is 20th of October. As per section 50, the interest is payable next day after due date till the date of payment of tax. Come on, till the date of payment of tax. Here in problem, they have not given date of payment of tax. In RTP, I personally believe it is a mistake of RTP, but go with the RTP. Now, in RTP, they assume that date of payment of tax is same as date of payment to the advocate. Hence, they have taken date of payment . If you see the solution note number 4, date of payment is 11th of November. Hence, delay in payment 22 days from 21st October to 11th of November, 22 days, and calculate the interest for 22 days. Again, they presume date of payment of tax is same date as when payment made to advocate. This is the mistake of the problem given in RTP. But for your understanding here, date of payment, okay, I am explaining ki you have to assume ki date of payment of tax is same as date of payment to the advocate. Is it clear, beta? So, okay, these adjustments we have seen in this problem. Next question number 28. Bahut achha question hai, beta. Yes, really good question. Lekin, but you must understand, okay, each and every line of this question carefully. Aapka dhyan chahiye. XYZ Limited, a New Delhi manufacturer, biscuits under the brand name of Tasty Pix. Biscuits are supplied to wholesaler and distributor located across India on FOR basis. FOR matlab free on road, that means delivery at buyer destination. Matlab aap buyer ke ghar tak pahuncha ke de rahe ho. Warehouse of the company located at New Delhi. Company uses multiple mode of transport for supplying the biscuits to its customer spread across the country. Matlab transporter GTA ya railway or other mode of transport, alag-alag transport mode use kar rahi hai company. The transportation cost is shown as a line item in the invoice and billed to the customer with markup 2% of total amount of freight paid inclusive of taxes. Whatever is incurring transportation cost for transportation of biscuits, they are recovering from the customers. Wo apne customers se paisa recover kar rahe hai. They are showing that amount separately and 2% markup of total amount. What is this total amount? Freight plus taxes. Matlab समझ लो उनको जो भी फ्रेट लग रहा है कस्टमर तक पहुंचाने का, तो फ्रेट प्लस व्हाट एवर द जीएसटी पेड ऑन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, ओके, दैट फ्रेट प्लस जीएसटी ऑन दिस टोटल अमाउंट दे आर टेकिंग मार्कअप, 2% वो ऊपर मार्कअप ले रहे हैं एंड सप्लाइंग टू वेरियस कस्टमर. फ्लोर यूज फॉर प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस इज प्रोक्योर्ड फ्रॉम द वेंडर्स लोकेटेड इन मध्य प्रदेश ऑन एक्स फैक्ट्री बेसिस. दे आर यूजिंग वन इन फ्लोर and that floor purchased from a supplier Madhya Pradesh, unka floor ka supplier Madhya Pradesh mein hai. Company engaged the goods transport agency to transport the floor from factories of Windows to its factory located in New Delhi. The company has provided following data relating to the transportation of biscuits and flour in the month of April 2020. Okay, so remaining data is given. So try to understand the policy of the company. I already have drawn the diagram, and on the basis of this diagram, main puri case study explain karta hu. I will explain the case study. XYZ company in New Delhi, manufacturing their product biscuits, manufacturing their product biscuits, for that flour is used. For that flour is used. Now for transportation of biscuit to various customers, they are using transporter service, maybe GTA or other modes of transport, railway and etc. और जिसके लिए वो फ्रेट पे कर रहे हैं विथ GST. फॉर एग्जाम्पल फ्रेट 10,000 विथ GST 500 वो पे कर रहे हैं, बट वॉट एवर द फ्रेट दे इनकर्ड रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम द कस्टमर, कस्टमर से वो फ्रेट रिकवर भी कर रहे हैं. और फ्रेट जो रिकवर कर रहे हैं बेटा, यहाँ पे वैल्यू ऑफ बिस्किट्स एंड अ सेकेंड लाइन आइटम इज द फ्रेट, बट दिस फ्रेट इज 2% मार्कअप. कम ऑन, दिस फ्रेट इज 2% मार्कअप. मीन्स वॉट एवर द टोटल अमाउंट दे इनकर, 10,000 प्लस 500, 10,500 प्लस 2% मार्कअप ऑफ दिस 10,500 एंड दे आर रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम द कस्टमर 10,710. ओके, तो 2% मार्कअप करके दे आर रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम द कस्टमर 10,710 एंड इन इनवॉइस दे आर चार्जिंग 10,710 एज अ फ्रेट. ओके बेटा, सो now the flour their input is purchased from the supplier on x factory basis. Supplier is in Madhya Pradesh, MP, aur supplier se le rahe x factory basis pe. Ab ye x factory basis pe le rahe matlab kya kar rahe beta, x factory basis pe le rahe matlab ye ki transportation cost is incurred by company itself. That means in this case study the transportation cost is incurred by company for outward transportation, for their outward transportation as well as for their inward transportation. So outward as well as inward transportation, the company is incurring transportation cost. Is it clear? Okay, then this is a complete policy of the company. So in first paragraph we have tried to understood the policy of the company. Now let's analyze the data given by company. For sales within the NCR region, 20 lakhs, company arrange local mini van belonging to an individual and paid by him rupees 54,000. Okay. Second, for sales to a location in distinct state, 1,78,00,000, company has booked the goods by Indian Railway and paid the rail freight 3,17,000. Now second diagram, company अपना biscuit product sell कर रही है, और ये biscuit product जो company sell कर रही है यहाँ पे बेटा, so sell to NCR region within Delhi using minivan of individual, where freight paid is 54,000, is it clear? Freight paid is 54,000. Okay, and value 20 lakhs. Okay, beta, value 20 lakhs. Now, second, goods are sold. Okay, second information, goods are sold in different state where value is 1,78,00,000. For that, okay, rail. Goods are transported through rail where freight paid is 3,17,000. Is it clear? I have given GST element, but we will talk about this GST later on. Now, third information, let's see what they have given. Sales to location of neighboring state, 55,00,000. The company booked the goods by road, GTA, and paid the road freight 3,73,000 Out of total sales to neighboring state, goods worth 10 lakhs were booked through a GTA, which paid tax 12%, and freight of 73,000 was paid, okay, to such GTA. अब देखो तीसरा सेल क्या है. थर्ड केस में नेबरिंग स्टेट को वो सेल कर रहे हैं, और वो नेबरिंग स्टेट को जो सेल कर रहे हैं इसमें टोटल 55 लाख है, बट इनवॉइस ऑफ 45 लाख एंड इनवॉइस ऑफ 10 लाख. नाउ यहां पे 10 लाख के जो इनवॉइस है वहां जीटीए इज अंडर 12%. कम ऑन, जीटीए इज अंडर 12% एंड रिमेनिंग जीटीए अंडर 5%. फॉर जीटीए अंडर 12% फ्रेट पेड इज 73,000. अब जीटीए 12% है क्या, इफ यू रिमेंबर रिवर्स चार्ज कुछ याद आ रहा है आपको, जीटीए हैज एन टू ऑप्शन, ओके 12% एंड 5%. तो आउट ऑफ दिस टोटल फ्रेट 73,000 फ्रेट रिलेटेड टू जीटीए हु ऑप्टेड 5% एंड रिमेनिंग 3 लाख फ्रेट वेयर अंडर रिवर्स चार्ज मैकेनिज्म, रिमेनिंग 3 लाख ओके फ्रेट फ्रॉम सच ट्रांसपोर्टर हु हैज नॉट ऑप्टेड फ्रॉम 12%. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट. Purchase of flour from Madhya Pradesh 25 lakhs. Company booked a goods by GTA and paid road freight 55,000. Okay. Again, as I told you, for inward transportation company also incurred the expenses of GTA. Okay, जो flour खरीदा उसके लिए भी company ने GTA का payment किया है. So now XYZ Limited here purchased the flour from supplier 25 lakhs. For that freight paid is 55,000. I repeat, for that freight paid is 55,000. Next, purchase a butter pump Punjab 15 lakhs. The company booked the goods by GTA and paid road freight of 35,000. So again, second purchase, second input material is butter. Butter is purchased and that butter 15 lakhs for which freight paid is 35,000. Okay, now next. Local purchase of baking powder, company booked the goods GTA in a single carriage and paid road freight 1500. Third, baking powder is purchased. If you see, the baking powder is purchased and this baking powder, okay, for which is 1500. Done. 4. Transferring the biscuit at open market value 4 lakhs to one of his sister concern in Rajasthan. Company booked the goods by GTA and paid the road freight. Matlab kya? Jo final product biscuit tha, ek last wo apne sister concern ko de raha hai. Wo apne sister concern ko de raha hai. Jiske liye the freight paid is 40,000 and open market value is 4 lakhs. Done. Okay. Next, what they said, based on particular given above, compute GST payable on the amount paid for transportation by XYZ Limited when it avail the services of different transporters. Now try to understand this question carefully. They said on the basis of above, just calculate GST payable or paid on transportation services availed by XYZ Limited. That means whatever the outward transportation availed by XYZ Limited, service procured by XYZ Limited, and whatever the transportation service of inward transportation, matlab on procurement of inputs. So outward as well as inward transportation pe GST diya. Okay, you have to calculate that. Now, be careful. Here they have not said that ki just calculate GST payable under reverse charge. उन्होंने ये कहा है, what they said, कि calculate total GST, which may be under forward charge or reverse charge, calculate the total GST paid by company outward as well as inward supply. तो आपको forward charge में लगा होगा, GTA ने लगा के दिया होगा, या फिर reverse charge में आपने जो pay किया होगा, उसका total GST amount आपको, be careful in this area. Second, compute GST charge on transportation costs billed by company to the customer. Second one is important, GST charge on transportation costs. They have not said calculate GST on biscuits. They said only calculate GST charge on which is recovered from customer. As per policy, what they are recovering from the customer? 2% on total amount. Total, how to calculate total amount? Freight plus GST on procurement. तो उसका 2% मार्कअप कर, तो आप जितना रिकवर कर रहे हो, वॉट एवर यू आर रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम द कस्टमर ऑन दैट फ्रेट एलिमेंट कैलकुलेट जीएसटी, नॉट अज्यूम दैट रेट ऑफ जीएसटी ऑन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ गुड्स एंड बिस्किट्स इज 5% एंड 12%. नाउ वी अज्यूम द रेट एप्लीकेबल ऑन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ गुड्स 5% एंड बिस्किट्स 12%. बट देर इज वन केस वेयर फ्रेट पेड 73,000, आपको याद होगा, तो स्प्रेड जो है 73,000, यहां 5% अज्यूम नहीं करना है बिकॉज दिस इज क्लियरली गिवन ओके इन द प्रॉब्लम दैट सप्लायर हैज चार्ज 12% एंड ऑप्टेड फॉर 12%. ओके, सो लेट्स कैलकुलेट. ओके, लेट डिस्कस स्टेप बाय स्टेप सर्विस अवेल. सो वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट टू थिंग्स, कम ऑन, we have to calculate two things, what freight paid and GST on that, GST on that, on service avail, and what recover, what cost recovered from the customer and GST on that, come on, from the customer and GST on that. So try to understand here, minivan by an individual. If you refer the notes of this problem, ICAI has taken the that any minivan provided by an individual, then it is not a GTA, goods transport agency. Why? Because in earlier law, that is service goods transport agency, come on, goods transport agency means an agency who is operating a transportation of goods business and giving consignment note. मतलब कोई एजेंसी होनी चाहिए थी जिसके ऊपर जीएसटी आएगा. इफ कोई इंडिविजुअल अगर खुद के ट्रक में सर्विस देता है, इफ एनी इंडिविजुअल प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विसेज अंडर इन हिज ओन ट्रक और ओन वैन और ओन व्हीकल, वुड नॉट बी ट्रीटेड जीटीए, नॉट ट्रीटेड एज एजेंसी. उसे एजेंसी नहीं बोला जाएगा क्योंकि वो खुद के पर्सनल ट्रक में दे रहा है. तो इन दिस केस मिनी वैन हायर्ड, ओके, एंड दिस मिनी वैन इज नॉट ओन बाय एजेंसी, ओके, इट इज हायर्ड फ्रॉम इंडिविजुअल, तो ऐसे केस में ये जीटीए नहीं बोला जाएगा. नाउ पॉइंट नंबर टू, इफ यू रिमेंबर द एग्जम्पशन ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट सेक्टर, व्हाट दैट एग्जम्पशन सेड, ऑल ट्रांसपोर्टेशन बाय रोड, कम ऑन, ऑल ट्रांसपोर्टेशन बाय रोड इज एग्जम्प्टेड, ऑल ट्रांसपोर्टेशन बाय रोड इज एग्जम्प्टेड एक्सेप्ट जीटीए. सो मिनी वैन ऑपरेटेड बाय इंडिविजुअल इज नॉट अ जीटीए, हेंस it is an transportation of goods by road and exempted from the payment of tax. I personally believe ki if you read this adjustment with exemptions, okay, agar aapka exemption chapter ho gaya hoga to with exemptions that will be more beneficial. So here agar aapka exemption nahi hua hoga to wait, fir ye problem abhi mat karna, don't do this problem now. Okay, do this problem after exemption, but a very important problem. So this is about minivan exemption. So, no GST is payable, nil. Okay, yahan GST nil aayega. Acha, nil aayega to total value hui 54,000. What is our policy? What, 2% markup. Okay, and we will require freight from the customer with 2% markup. So 2% markup on 54,000. Just a minute. So it would be 55,080 you are going to recover from the customer. Is it clear, beta? Okay, with this 2% markup you can refer also in answer. Okay, answer dekho. Now on this 54,000 GST is nil as it is exempt, ye diya hai. And in next table right side on this 54,000 no GST is paid, but 2% mark 55,080, okay, which we are recovering from the customer. Now next, second one. Second consignment, okay, to different state by rail. In case of rail, no reverse charge is applicable, only forward charge is applicable. And transportation of goods by rail or by GTA, the applicable rate given 5%. Hence, on 317,000 freight, GST at the rate 5% is 15,850. So, if you see in the answer, then transportation of goods by Indian Railway 317,000, and GST 15,850. So what you incurred? Now let's recover this amount from the customer. So total is 317,000. First 15,850. Just a minute. 317,000 plus 15,850. The total is 332,850. Into 2%, 6650 plus 57. So your amount should be 2% markup, you are going to recover 339,507 from the customer. 339,507 from the customer. Is it clear? See the answer, 339,000. So in case, second case, yes, by railway. See that second table. 317,000, 15,850, 339,507. You are going to recover from the customer. Chalo. Now third one. Third one, there are two invoices. One under 12% and remaining under 5%. The freight 73,000 is under 12% on which GST is 8760. So in first table, if you see, then GST, it's 8760 and remaining 3 lakhs, on remaining 3 lakhs, GST at the rate 5% under reverse charge. Under reverse charge, that is 15,000. So here 15,000, to aapko mil jayega ye table mein, ye dekho 3 lakhs aur uska 15,000, where reverse charge is applicable. Now ab aise case mein yahan pe beta, see what you are going to recover. Total 73,000 plus 81,760, and here 3,15,000. So you are going to recover from the customer 2% markup into 315,000 into 2% plus 6,300. You are going to recover here 321,000 from the customer, and in first case 81,760 into 2%, 1635. That is 83,396. So you will get here in second table, dekho, what amount you are going to recover? 3,15,000. So total 3,21,300 aaya tha hamara. 73,8760. So 83,395 or 396. You are going to recover from the customer. Now, next. Here you have provided the goods to your sister concern. Sister concern, yes, transportation cost is incurred, but this amount you are not going to charge to customer because it is your sister concern. So here 40,000, on this 40,000 GST is payable. In this problem, they assume that, okay, there is no markup on transportation cost billed to sister concern. Okay, that observe, they have taken the assumption ki no markup, hence this transaction is not taken in given problem. Okay, whatever the cost incurred for sister concern, because there is no markup and no transportation cost is also considered. This is an assumption taken by RTP, okay, whatever it may be. So this is related to what you record from the customer. But if here no markup, but आपने सर्विस तो लिया था, और अगर आपने सर्विस लिया है तो 40,000 का आपको तो कॉस्ट इनकर्ड हुआ था, यू हैव इनकर्ड दैट कॉस्ट 40,000 का, ओके, जीएसटी आपको लगा है ना, यू आर नॉट रिकवर्ड फ्रॉम द ओके योर सिस्टर कंसर्न, बट ओके आपने वो कॉस्ट पे किया, तो आपको दो टेबल बनाने हैं, व्हाट द कॉस्ट यू इनकर्ड, कम ऑन, व्हाट द कॉस्ट यू इनकर्ड एंड व्हाट यू रिकवर्ड फ्रॉम द कस्टमर. तो आपको जो कॉस्ट लगी वो तो आपने ले लिया, हियर 2000. ये तो हुआ बेटा आपका आउटवर्ड सप्लाई. लेट्स कैलकुलेट द जीएसटी यू पेड ऑन फ्रेट ऑफ इनवर्ड सप्लाई. इनवर्ड सप्लाई में अब देखो, आपने फ्लोर ट्रांसपोर्ट किया था. नाउ अगर आपको याद होगा तो नाउ अंडर एग्जम्पशन इफ यू ट्रांसपोर्ट द गुड्स विच इंक्लूड्स मिल्क, सॉल्ट या फ्लोर, सो इट इज एग्जम्प्टेड फ्रॉम जीएसटी. इसलिए फ्लोर पे कोई जीएसटी नहीं लगेगा. तो इसलिए अगर आप पहला टेबल देखते हो तो नाउ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ फ्लोर 50,000 नील जीएसटी, इसके ऊपर जीएसटी नहीं लगेगा. ओके, तो आपको पहले टेबल में क्या करना है, इन फर्स्ट टेबल ऑन आउटवर्ड सप्लाई इनवर्ड सप्लाई जो भी आपने जीएसटी दिया वो पूरा आपको कैलकुलेट करना है. इज इट क्लियर? तो आपने यहां पे जीएसटी नहीं दिया है तो ये आप कैलकुलेट कर सकते हो. नेक्स्ट, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ बटर बाय जीटीए, तो बटर एग्जम्प्टेड नहीं है बेटा, इसलिए 35,000 का 5% इसके ऊपर ओके जीएसटी आएगा. एग्जम्पशन मिल्क को है, मिल्क पाउडर को नहीं, ये बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड है. ओके, एग्जम्पशन इज गिवन टू मिल्क एंड नॉट टू मिल्क पाउडर. ओके, तो ऐसे केस में इस पर जीएसटी आएगा. एंड नेक्स्ट, ओके, बेकिंग पाउडर जो है, बेकिंग पाउडर के केस में इन अ कंसाइनमेंट 1500 का ओके यहां पे फ्रेट लगा, तो अगेन देयर इज वन एग्जम्पशन फॉर जीटीए फॉर अ कंसाइनमेंट इन अ अमाउंट इज 1500, तो वो एग्जम्पशन मिलेगा, वो केस में भी जीएसटी नहीं लगेगा. तो फर्स्ट केस में ऑल आउटवर्ड सप्लाई और इनवर्ड सप्लाई पे कितना जीएसटी लगा है उसका टेबल दिया है. और सेकंड केस में बेटा यहां पे अगर आप देखते हो तो जो कस्टमर से हमने निकाला है, ओके, रिकवर किया है विद 2% मार्कअप, उसका यहां पे जो है उन्होंने फ्रेट दिया है. नाउ व्हाट दे सेड कि कैलकुलेट जीएसटी व्हाट एवर यू रिकवर्ड फ्रॉम द कस्टमर अ फ्रेट एलिमेंट. तो जो आपने फ्रेट एलिमेंट लिए उसके ऊपर जीएसटी निकालो, ये दिया हुआ है. अब देखो यहां थोड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट है क्या, तो अब यहां ये जो आपने फ्रेट एलिमेंट रिकवर किया है इसके ऊपर जीएसटी कैलकुलेट करना है. रेट क्या है, अगर रेट आपने 5% लिया तो गलत हो जाएगा. यहां रेट होगा 12%. 12% क्यों, व्हाई द रेट इज 12%, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. यू हैव रिकवर्ड दिस अमाउंट इन योर इनवॉइस, कब, 55,080 अलॉन्ग विद सेल ऑफ बिस्किट्स और 3,39,507 अलॉन्ग विद बिस्किट. इफ यू रिमेंबर कंपोजिट सप्लाई, तो कंपोजिट सप्लाई में हमने देखा था इफ फ्रेट चार्जेस अलॉन्ग विद द सेल ऑफ मेन गुड्स, देन ओके इट इज ट्रीटेड एज पार्ट ऑफ कंपोजिट सप्लाई नेचुरली बंडल्ड. हेंस अ रेट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल सप्लाई दैट इज बिस्किट्स, रेट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल सप्लाई दैट इज बिस्किट इज अप्लीकेबल टू फ्रेट एलिमेंट. हेंस हियर ऑन फ्रेट बिस्किट्स रेट इज अप्लीकेबल, और बिस्किट का रेट क्या है बेटा, 12%. तो ऐसे सिचुएशन में ओके यहां पे ऑन बिस्किट्स यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट, सॉरी ऑन फ्रेट एलिमेंट ऑफ बिस्किट यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट जीएसटी एट द रेट 12% which is given in the problem and we have calculated the GST at the rate 12%. So this is okay a complete problem about all transportation. You must have to write every element that about exemptions, come on, about exemptions, okay, RCM, then outward transportation, inward transportation, most of the notes I have covered in table. Okay, as well as here, why you applied the rate 12%? The 12% rate is applicable because when you are going to recover freight from the customer, it is a part of composite supply, and rate of biscuit is applicable for the whole transportation cost. So ये था ये problem, बहुत अच्छा problem बेटा यहाँ पे. Okay, question number 28. हमने 28 discuss किया.